Hello and welcome to Bob and Talk. In this video, I want to show you how you can use the add layer print here in the object browser and then open the texture editor and create your own print with many variations and layers and whatever you like to add. So I do have a piece of fabric here. I put a silk taffeta on a hanger and just a couple of pins to hold it in place. And you can see it here in the 2D window. So let's come to the object browser and you can see that my fabric is already here and I have the property editor already open on the right side. So I'm gonna left click once on silk taffeta just so I have my properties open. And then if you take a look on the right side, you will see a little roll of fabric and then you can see the add print button. It looks like a little plus button. So let's left click once on that and that will navigate you to the layer, to the folders where you can search. Hopefully you have all of your fabrics, prints, graphics organized. So I am gonna come to my print folder and I'm gonna open a PNG file with a transparent background. So I know that this will overlay nicely over my fabric. So I have this segment here that I will open and this will populate it in the object browser. And you can see that it already created a repeat of stripes here. And it's also in the texture right here on the right side under property editor. So one thing that I want to point out is that under configuration in face, you can change where this print is laying. Right now it is on the front of the fabric. I can choose this to be in the drop down menu to be on the back, for example. So you can see how it switched to the back of the fabric. I could also choose this to be on both front and back. And now you can see that it is on both sides. So this can be useful if you want to quickly create a lining with a different print or anything like that. For now, I will just keep it on the front of my fabric. You can see that I selected and it switched to just the front. And the next thing I want to do is I want to come to basic parameters, make sure that this is open so you can see texture. And to the right of texture, you can see that this print is already populated here. Navigate to the right where you see the little paintbrush. This will say open texture editor. Left click on that and that will open up your texture editor window. So you can see that my print is here. It's on the left side. It's visible. If I click the little eye, we will see just the base fabric. So I'm going to click show to make sure I see it. And in here in the window, I'm just going to enlarge a little bit more so I can see more of this print. So now in this window here on the left side, you can keep adding new layers just like in other programs like Photoshop. You can keep bringing graphics or layers and create a new one. So you can bring these in various ways. One of them is you open your library and your fabric and you drag it and drop it. You could also just click the add plus button here. And again, this navigates me to my particular folder. So I am going to look for another print, for example. So this time I'm just gonna grab a something that you may want to bring. It's a tie-dye swatch. You may want to maybe enlarge this and have it cover the whole background. And you can see that it is on top of this one as a layer. So if I keep enlarging, it will cover. If I don't want it to cover my current print, I could just simply drag it underneath. And this will change the positioning of the two layers. You could also play with the opacity and make one of these layers more opaque so that you can see it better. What I actually want to do is I want to create a stripe to work with this one. So I'm going to come here to this gizmo tool and I will make sure that it does come to the edges but I actually want to shrink this to be a skinny stripe. So something like that might look good to you, where it's overlapping on one side. You could also grab it and change it and move it so that it creates this kind of overlap. Always take a look here in the 3D window if you can't see it well here, and make sure that if you want it to be edge to edge, that it is going edge to edge. You could also come here and under repeat, click on extend to other side if you have individual elements. But in this case, I just want to extend it right here on the window. And also I want to kind of see if this makes sense in terms of overlapping. So you may want to move the print a little bit up and down, or maybe even scale it so that you get a better transition, because you would see the line here. So ideally you want a perfect repeat there where the transition is nice and smooth. Now, I actually want to create a bit more of a stripe, and I'm going to center it a little bit more. And now I have created a brand new print with the two different graphic elements, and I am editing them here in the texture editor. I can keep bringing new ones, so let's do one more here and find something that might look interesting. So I'm going to bring another graphic bright color element, and this time I am going to position it horizontally, and I'm going to extend that all the way through. And you can see that now I have somewhat of a plaid here in my 3D window, and I am pretty happy with how this particular print looks like. And keep in mind that here in the window, you can change the order if you want one of these to overlap another one. Right now I have this chevron right on top of the other ones. And another thing that I want to point out here is the blend menu. This can play a really good role in terms of how you want these colors or these hues to interact with each other. So I have some really bright colors, and I may want to choose some of these to be maybe more of a soft light, for example, or hard light. So soft light will, you can see the difference here that it dimmed it almost like a transparency. A hard light would do the opposite. It would make it really bright and vivid and still blending with the other colors. So this is completely up to you of how you want to blend your different fabrics, and you have that options for each one of these layers. So you can click on each one of these and choose the different modes here. I have another video where I explain the layouts and all of these different options here. And keep in mind that once you're happy with a particular layer, you can lock it. So as you're editing the other ones, this one doesn't change anymore. And you can do that for each one of these. When you're happy and finished with this, make sure that you apply the changes. Don't just cancel. If you cancel this window, it's going to close everything and not save anything. You won't even get a pop-up window if you just click cancel. You can close the window here with the X button on the top right, and this will give you a warning. Do you want to save? But if you just click cancel, you're not going to see any warning. If you want to make sure that this is applied to the texture and you just want to close, I recommend the apply and close button. Before you do that, you can also toggle between your 2D and 3D window if there's anything you want to check here. Come back to the texture editor, and I recommend again to apply and close, and then move on to working with the textile. Save your file, save the project, and also if you take a look and click under basic parameters on the texture, you will see that you already have this file saved in temporary file. You can also copy this one and create this file as a new print and save it in a designated folder where you will have it forever. So I hope that was helpful and useful to you, Now you know how you can create textures and prints in CLO instead of using Photoshop or any other software. This way you stay in the software and utilize it within your garments or whatever else you're doing. Thank you for watching Bobbin Talk, and I hope to see you in the next video.